Hi guys, it's me and Keisha here at the Enchanted Dreamcatcher, and welcome back to another video. Sorry, my hair is really bugging me. So if you are new to my channel and just happen to stumble across this part of YouTube, welcome. I am Keisha. Obviously I am the Enchanted Dreamcatcher. I post new videos twice a week on a Wednesday and a Friday at 6 o'clock, and I mainly talk about witchcraft, magic, manifestation, law of attraction, goal setting, beauty, and a little bit of everyday life thrown in there as well. So I hope you enjoy my video, and so without further ado, let's get. So this video we are going to, or I'm going to be doing a updated what's in my bag. I love these type of videos. I don't know why. I think you probably love them more if you have a obsession like with handbags and stuff like I do. I love nothing more than a good handbag. Yeah, so I just find that, I don't know, I just love to see how people organize their bags, like what they keep in their bags and everything like that. I just find it really, I just find it really fun, and I just think it's just really cool. So let's do mine. So this is my latest handbag. I got this recently. I've only really been using it the last week or so, and it's quite heavy as I've got a lot in it. It's like a big sort of tote bag, and I love the pattern. I love the white with the floral, sort of very spring like. It's by the brand Fiorelli. It's an Italian handbag brand, and I've bought quite a few handbags in the past from them, and I just love the quality, love their designs, and yeah, so I got this one. This one was actually on sale. I think it was reduced from like £70 to 26 something. I think I got the last one in this pattern, but they do have same bag on sale in like sort of different patterns, so you have to check it out. So as I said, it's just a tote bag. You can put it on your shoulder. I do put it on my shoulder. The handles aren't huge, so if you had like a big puffy coat or something, you probably struggle a bit having it on your shoulder, but you can make it work. It kind of reminds me like a beach bag almost. It's that same sort of style. So this, it's like in and out the bag, just a flap with a popper. And as you can see, or you probably can't see because I'm really suck at this. Let's fall over. It's just a, it's a very large sort of, it's not really a structured bag. It has, actually the actual bag is quite structured, but there's not sort of like different compartments and stuff in it. So as you saw, it's one big compartment, and then there's a zip pocket at the back, and then there's two little open pockets at the front. I think they're sort of supposed to be like for your phone or whatever, but I think my phone would be too big to fit in there. So let's dive on in. So as you can see, I do have quite a lot in there. And see what I was on about, those pockets are quite small. I don't think you'd be able to fit any sort of like normal fit. I mean, I've got an iPhone 11 Pro Max. I wouldn't fit that in there. But I guess if you had a small older iPhone, maybe like an iPhone 6 or something, I guess you'd probably fit it. I don't know. But so that's my purse, first of all. It's just an old, it's not really that old. I got it last year from River Island. I did actually buy a handbag to match, but I didn't like the handbag, but I've still kept using the purse. So I've just got my driver's license there that I'm covering up, and just sort of like bank cards, debit cards, loyalty cards, that sort of thing. And then there's some just receipt and some change in there as well. I'm not really taking it out in any order, I suppose. So this little pouch was starting to wear a little bit, but I got from Michael's a couple of years ago. I just love it. It's a little purple from the Recollections collection. It's a little mermaid, and I just keep a couple of pens in there, some washi tape, there's a couple of binder clips, little pack of stickers, and some little like post-it note type thing. So I always keep that in any handbag that I have. So if I need to write anything down or anything like that, I'm prepared. I have some pain relief. These were actually from when I last went to America recently. So these are extra strength, or they're like Tylenol, but they're a Kroger brand. I have a little hairbrush, little rose gold hairbrush. I think I got it from Boots for like $125 or something, and I've just got a little hair bubble on there in case I ever need to comb through my hair or tie my hair up or anything like that. So I'm always know where everything is. I have my makeup bag, a Benefit one. It's very pretty, pink and glittery, but literally that glitter just gets everywhere. So we can go through my makeup bag quickly if you want. There's some tampons, hand cream. That one is from, I'll go for Christmas. I think it's from Sainsbury's, like in a set. It's a shea butter one. So I have a Soap and Glory brand bronzer, the solar powder. I can open it. I can open it. Why won't you open? Oh my god. There we go. So I've hit pan pretty bad on that. So I'm like nearly done on that. I need another one really. So let's just grab it out at once. I haven't actually got that much in there. I have a Soap and Glory lip gloss, the Sexy Mother Pucker one. And that one is in the shade Plum Sup. That one's quite nice, like a pinky glittery colour that I just dropped. have a NYX Esmeralda. That's the shade eyeliner. That's like an eye pencil. Just a pretty green colour. I have an It mascara, like one of my favorite mascaras ever, the superhero mascara. It's like amazing. I have a Mali lip gloss and just sort of more like a nudie pink color. It's called Pink Daisy, is that one. I have a Unique Lucrative lip gloss in Livid. I like the Unique ones and because they come with a little mirror, which I think is super duper handy. So yeah, I have that. And if you are wanting to check out, they have loads of colours. I have the link in the description box so you can check them out. I also have a Unique Moonstruck Precision Pencil Eyeliner in Purposeful. It's just a really nice, like, that needs sharpening. I can't use it anymore, but it's a really nice, like, royal purple. So it's lovely. I had, my kabuki brush is in here. It needs a clean so bad, but I think I got this one from Boots like a few years ago, so it's just like a random one. And this is a mirror my mom got for my birthday, just a little pocket mirror that comes in this pouch. She got me that a couple of years ago, I think. So I haven't got much left. Got a Doll 10 lip crayon, which I do actually really like the color on it. It's like a barely legal, that one's called. It's like a really pretty pink. Some tweezers, some slanted tweezers, and a retractable lip brush. It's a unique one. And then this is just a random old eyeshadow brush. Another eyeliner buried at the bottom. I think this one's a Barry M one. It's so old, I don't even know what color it is. I think it's worn off. So yeah, that's everything in my makeup bag. And I have a planner. As what kind of girl would I be if I didn't have a planner in my bag? As if you follow me for ages, you know I love stationery, love planners, love books, love... Ooh, I do love them, even though I dropped that. So this one, I got this year from Paper Chase. And I just fell in love with it. It's like a rose gold colour with a pretty, pretty mandala design. And it has a pop snap closure. That's some paperwork there. And see how pretty that is. And I just really, really like it. Has a ribbon marker. And I like how the start of each month there is an exercise that I obviously haven't done yet this month. But think positively, find somewhere quiet, close your eyes, focus and relax. Think of 5 positive things about yourself, repeat it to yourself until you hear the word. And then so what were your positive affirmations? So each, it's sort of like a week on 2 pages, but I really like, and there's like a little bit at the bottom, like I feel, so you can sort of catch up with how you felt and things. And so each month I really like that there's a different exercise to do and stuff that really sort of thought provoking and gets you thinking and stuff. So I really like that. So that's my planner for this year. My book. Told you I love books. Always keep a book in my bag. This is, I'm on the last one in the Mortal Instruments series. I've had these books for so long and I've never got around to reading them and they're amazing. So this is City of Lost Souls by Cassandra Clare. So I am reading that at the moment. I always keep that in my bag. Is when I'm at work, I read every lunch time, every sort of lunch break. I only get half an hour, but I usually manage to read about 20 pages or so. This is, or was, my nail file, especially when I have my shellac nails done, which I haven't got at the moment, but when I do have them, I always keep that in my bag just in case any chips or anything, so I can just like file them down. Some tissues, more tampons, more painkillers, is a ibuprofen, sunglasses, the case, I think it's from Accessorize. The sunglasses are from the brand Coco Mint from iSpace. They're a little dusty as it hasn't really been the weather to wear sunglasses yet this year. But I like them for like, I just think they're quite cool. Sort of kind of a retro, almost a cat eye shape. There's sort of like tortoise shell and they're just, yeah, they're pretty. And so when the weather gets nicer again, hopefully soon I'll be able to start rocking these sunglasses. I have a little pouch. With, if I can get them out, some tarot cards. So I keep those in my bag. These are the mini everyday tarot. So that's cool. So I'm trying to do readings when I can and stuff. I'm not too hot on the like illustrations and the color scheme and stuff. I don't really, not really a big fan, but I like the size of them. I wanted and like a mini deck for my handbag. And when I was in Barnes and Noble back in like October, I saw them and I was like, oh, this will be perfect. And that pouch is so handy because it just fits them, but it doesn't fit the little guidebook, so I keep that in my zip pocket in the back of my handbag. And then the last couple of bits in those little small pockets at the front. So, one pocket I have a unique roll-on perfume, which, or a rollerball one, which is a Dreaming of You. It's quite a nice scent. I have another lip gloss, another Soap and Glory one, and the Sexy Mother Pucker one. This one is in the shade Nude Star. I love the sort of plumping lip glosses that you can get, as you can just really feel the tingling on your lips, and I love that. This is a little handbag size spray perfume that I'm nearly out of, but I've got another one. It's actually an Avon one. It's the Far Away Rebel. I just really, really love the scent of that one. Then in my last pouch, I have, what do I have? I have some more painkillers. This time I have paracetamol. And a little stress check roll-on by This Works. I'm not sure, essential oils, but it doesn't say what essential oils are in it, but it smells really good. Sometimes when I'm feeling a bit stressed out and stuff, I either roll it on my temples or my wrists, or what I like to do is roll it on a tissue, and it absorbs really well, and then I just sort of like keep smelling it throughout the day to have me feel relaxed and stuff. And I have two little half packets of chewing gum, Wrigley's Extra Cool Breeze, for anyone that wants that flavor. So yeah, that's everything in my bag, but my bag's quite big. I said all my legs were seasoned up there. I said it was, yeah, it could fit quite a lot of stuff in there. I could fit more into it. I wanted a big bag, like a big bag. I mean, I don't really like small bags unless I'm just popping out for the day. Just so, because I tend to do a lot of work on my MacBook. I tend to like go to like coffee shops like Starbucks and stuff, and sit and do things on my MacBook. And I take my other like everyday planner with me as well. And I just wanted something where I could just chuck everything in. And yeah, so I really like it. And yeah, that's the latest for my handbag. But yeah, now I've got to put all this away. I've actually just scattered it on the floor. I swear, like, some, like, when you see these videos normally, like, the YouTubers that film them are like super smart, and they're like, they like take something out, they show you what it is, and they like put it straight back in and stuff. But no, I thought I'd be super clever and just put it on the floor, and now I've got a mess that I've got to clean up. So yeah, that was a good one, Keisha, well done. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Comment below if you have any suggestions or anything like that, and also I'd love to see like what your like current handbag setup is and stuff. So like, tag me in any videos that you've done, or you can send me any pictures or whatever, because I'm like super nosy. I love looking in people's handbags. But anyway, I'm gonna start rambling, as I've been rambling for like nearly 20 minutes. So, super long video. Hope you enjoy it, and I will see you very soon in my next video. Until next time, keep dreaming and stay enchanted.